unless we make fighting corruption blindness. That is not clearing whose ox is gone. Challenging, trying, prosecuting every person that is corrupt, regardless of the status whether they are a president, a governor, or a minister. So, and then you must fight them to the last. It's not enough to say, well, arrested them, and then they begin to play games. I'm a lawyer. I know games we lawyers play in criminal trials. And that's why I've suggested repeatedly that we should have special courts to deal with corruption. Corruption is too serious for us to handle it like a game, like a football match. No. Those who are corrupt, who are suspected of corruption, should not be perceived innocent. They should prove their innocence. Those who are corrupt, when before they enter public community, they declare their assets. They are supposed to declare their assets, some don't. But when they declare their assets, at the end they must also declare their assets. The difference between what they had when they went to the park and what they have when they are leaving power should be regarded as a matter to be properly investigated. And if it exceeds what we consider their normal income, they should now explain their ill-gotten gains. And it is not they, it is not the constitution that should prove their innocence, it is they who should prove their innocence. Now, I have said that many of our leaders have little or no knowledge of what they are supposed to do. And that is where I'm very happy that we have our young ones here. Because and we, as leaders who are in the country, have been taking our governments to task. We have insisted on them that it is bad policy to say religion is no longer compulsory. It's no longer what they call a core subject. We have fought this. We got the former President Obasanjo to agree that religion will be restored as a compulsory subject in primary and secondary education. Excuse me. Will be redressed by your own conviction, attitude, and behavior. Because, and it's not going to be strange, America leads the world today. And remember, the Americans, main Americans, came from Europe, came from Africa. So, from this land of so many people coming together, the standard of life to live, whether politics or economics, is dictated in America. And I sincerely hope that the standard of leadership for Nigeria will be dictated by our sons and daughters based in America today.
Kebeullah, Kebeullah.